morning. I'm Kirstin. I'm a taxi driver. I do about 70,000 miles a year. And I probably spend about 20% of my turnover in diesel, so any sort of fuel. I'm currently driving a Mercedes Viano. And with that in mind and all the benefits the state is giving us in regard to switching over to an electric car, I thought this was a good idea. You don't need to pay road tax. There's a lot less maintenance because there's obviously a lot less vibration in the car. And I went to drive a Tesla Model S, test drive it for 45 minutes, which I thoroughly enjoyed because the car is so well designed to just be that, an electric car. It tells you, you know, where you can refill, whether these chargers are occupied. It actually directs you there. It gives you assistance of staying in your lane. You can actually see on your screen all the oncoming traffic. It is just, and it is a really, really silent, lovely, lovely drive. And it's really nippy. It's a very fast car. And also, the minute you take your foot off the accelerator, it brakes with the engine and regenerates battery charge through that. And it basically drives like a motorbike. I drive a motorbike as well, so I have a bit of an idea there. So obviously Tesla is not the cheapest, and my Viano is a seven-seater taxi. So if I would go for a Tesla, I would probably need to go for a Model X. I think they started about £90,000. I don't have £90,000, and I also would lose one seat. I would have de facto a six-seater taxi. Plus, there's the Energy Trust, which will assist you with some interest-free loans, but they are not applicable to vehicles above £50,000, which the Tesla Model X would be definitely. So next best thing would be to drive a Mercedes e-Vito. They are on the market, and Mercedes, with Mercedes courtesy, I picked up a Mercedes e-Vito on Friday last week. And this is what I'm driving right now. I'm sitting in it. It's a nine-seater car. It would be an eight-seater taxi. It drives really, really nice. It is very nippy for, being a big car and obviously having heavy batteries underneath it. It doesn't brake quite as well as the Tesla did, I think, and it also doesn't have the same sort of feel of taking the foot off the accelerator and you get immediately engine brake. It does recharge, obviously, if you take the foot off the accelerator. Also recharges if you go downhill. So, with that said, it is very much a Vito like you expected. It has very comfy seats. It has all the, fittings any other Vito has. We have a Vito pretty much like this in our fleet. And it is, a comfy car. So I picked it up on Friday. I drove it from there to my home, which, usually is 52 miles. In the world of e-Vitos, it was over 60 miles. And what I hadn't realized is, unlike a Tesla, you cannot charge the Mercedes e-Vito at home. You can't just plug it into your home electricity or power sockets. So therefore, I had planned a trip going to Forres, which would be 140 something miles from my home. But prior to that, I needed to recharge the car, because by the time I had reached home, I was at 49% of charge. And that is, somewhere at, 115 miles range. The total range of the Mercedes is 230. So anyway, I took it the following day after my work into St. Andrews. I hooked it up to the charger. The lights went on. I even, had a conversation with the charging people over the phone because I didn't quite know how to work it. Off I went. I had something to eat. And when I came back, I realized that the car had charged 0 miles. I didn't have much time because I had an early start the next day on work. So I drove it home and I left it at home for the next 2 days. And the day before I intended to take it up to Forres, I took it back up to St. Andrews. I hooked it up to the charger. I finally figured out how to do that, which was quite difficult because Mercedes doesn't really have in the manual a chapter on charging. You will find it in the index in the back. And there is a menu button on the screen so that you can actually see whether it isn't charging. And it didn't charge over the app beforehand. It did charge when I was just using my bank card. So that worked fantastically. It took me four attempts to actually get it to charge. It also took the help of some Tesla drivers who had plugged in their car next to me while I had just arrived. So they assisted me with one charger, then the other charger. Eventually we got the charger I was at to work, and that wasn't the rapid charger, so I changed over to a rapid charger, by which time the lovely Tesla people had been spending more than 15 minutes in the charging bay, and their car was actually charged 80%, so off they went. I also went off and I had a walk with my boyfriend in town. I had some fish and chips, and after an hour and a half, an hour and 31 minutes to be precise, I returned to the charger to find out that the car had charged 28%, which was by no way enough to actually get to Forest the next day. So I took a lift with my boyfriend home and left the car charging overnight. So the next morning I needed to then take my combustion engine Viado into St. Andrews to then change all my luggage into the electric car, and off I drove. It was 143 miles to where I wanted to go. I started driving and I had 261 miles. I think when I pulled out of the parking bay, I had something like 248 miles. And by the time the car indicated it had done 100 miles, all it had done was 66. So round about Aberdeen, I got quite worried if I would actually make it to Forres. I did, and by the time I got to Forres, I had something like 44% charge left, which was roughly about 60 miles. So far, so good. I then decided I was going on a photographic retreat, so I drove up to a charging station, which didn't work. And then I drove up to another charging station, which I couldn't find. And then I went to the meeting point with my fellow photographic retreat people, and I left the car there. We did the first morning session, and then I got I got one of the ladies to drive me to a charging point, which could only charge, which was a non-tether charging point. So that meant I needed to plug in the car with my own cable. That worked. I left the car there while we went on our afternoon session. And a similar thing, I think the car had charged 3 hours and 50 minutes, and it was at something like 68%. So that did me for the remaining time of the retreat. The last day, or the last evening of my retreat, I decided I would leave the car at a sort of tea room close to my accommodation. So I drove up there after our day of retreat, only to find out the charger wasn't working. So then I drove past my past my accommodation again, back into the next town, which was Forres. I found the same charger again, where I needed to, use my own cable. I plugged it in, and I took an hour walk home of 2 miles to my accommodation. Next morning, same thing. I took the 2 mile walk back to the car. Then I needed to drive the car back to the accommodation to actually do my packing. And then I did the last bit of my retreat. So far, so good. At the end of the retreat, I, packed up my car and off I went. I had 155 miles because I actually intended to drive the car through the skiing area, which I did, which was quite surprising, because obviously if you go downhill, you do a lot of charging. So you actually gain some miles, which was lovely. But at the same time, I found the brakes quite worrying, because the car is really, really heavy and we have sort of 20% decline. So that was a bit of an issue. So I did, travel all through. It was no problem. I arrived back at St. Andrews because I obviously needed to return the car again back to Mercedes. And by the time I hit St. Andrews, or I would have hit home, I would have not made it back into Edinburgh. So I plugged in the car overnight. I changed all my luggage over into my combustion engine Viano. I took my Viano home. I had a good night's sleep. I took the Viano to the next train station. I took a taxi from the train station to the Vito, to the electric Vito, and I'm now driving back to Mercedes. So, as a summary, it is such a nice idea to drive an electric car. It would work with a Tesla. I don't have the money for the Tesla yet. It doesn't really work with the Mercedes. I think a minimum charge for the e-Vito should probably be, you know, like the Tesla, you know, 380, 350, maybe 400 miles, something like that. I believe Mercedes does the S-Class with a range of 600 miles. That would be lovely in an e-Vito. And, you know, just to give a comparison, I mean, I can't give you anything on prices. I shall update this video as soon as I have actually got some indication what I have been charged for charging this car. But obviously, you know, I had some costs. I needed a lift. I needed to walk a lot. I needed to take my own car to actually be able to go in the electric Vito. And also, to be fair, my Viano, I could have filled up for whatever it is, 80 pounds. And I would have not needed to do anything on my retreat. So this car, as, you know, as lovely as it drives, as comfortable as it is, and as, you know, it is obviously possible to charge it and to go about places. But, you know, with customers, I can't wait for, you know, 4 hours to recharge something. I could wait for, you know, 3/4 of an hour, that would work. So, you know, for business, it's not really feasible. Also, it is a bit tedious, you know, it's quite worrisome. It's a very needy car, you know, all you seem to be doing is looking out for charging points. And, you know, again, with a Viano, all I would have needed to do was fill it up and run it for, you know, the entire number of, for the whole shebang, I wouldn't have needed to refill it. So, I'm so sorry, Mercedes, but not yet, and not like this. Also, what I find very disconcerting, I mean, it's a lovely quiet drive. If I shut up for a moment, you will hear very little. If you put the foot down, it accelerates really well, but it also makes quite a hissing noise. So it gives you the slight inclination of sitting somewhere in a dentist's chair and somebody's drilling holes into your teeth. I shall stay back here a little bit and then, you know, just for the trial of it, give it a little bit of a yee-haw. Just bear with me. I need to just hold back a little bit. Now, here we go. I hope you can hear that. It does go like stink, which is lovely. But it makes a funny sound. Anyway, so with that said, it was a very good experience. If I want to be more mindful and if I wouldn't be a taxi driver, you know, I would probably walk a lot more, because the next morning, I mean, I had to walk down, you know, back to my accommodation, the 2 miles in complete darkness, which was beautiful. There was a nice moon, nice starlight, but I was walking on the main road, so that wasn't so pleasant, and I needed to jump into the ditch every now and again. On the way back, next morning, I managed to go through some forestry. It was a lovely, lovely walk. So if I wouldn't need to work, if I would be retired, or I don't know, if I just want to, you know, be a bit more mindful, it would be quite a nice car. And the other thing I had thought of, which I didn't do, of course, is because this is not my car. If I would have taken my bike, that would have been quite joyful too. So, you know, you could possibly combine your electric car with a bike if you can't charge it at home. But to be fair, you know, you really, if you sleep and the car can charge at your home, that would be most sensible. I mean, my next town is 10 miles away, so that's not really feasible to walk. So anyway, I leave you to it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope it has given you a little bit of an insight of what it is like to try to drive an electric vehicle. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.